Did you know that recently the European Commission adopted new regulations that will put an end to greenwashing and sustainability reports? These measures are meant to make European investors shift to more sustainable technologies and businesses. In that matter, what is the EU taxonomy and why is it so important? In order to reach the climate objectives set in the European Green Deal, the European Union has committed to direct investments towards sustainable business activities and make our economies more resilient against environmental wrecks. And to achieve those goals, the EU has set a clear definition of what activities can be defined as sustainable. As a result, the EU taxonomy was created as a common classification system for sustainable economic activities. Why do we need the EU taxonomy? Providing clear and concise input on which economic activities are considered environmentally sustainable, the EU expects to create peace of mind for investors and prevent greenwashing. The taxonomy established six environmental objectives: climate change mitigation, climate change adaptation, the sustainable use and protection of water and marine resources, the transition to a circular economy, pollution prevention and control, the protection and restoration of biodiversity and ecosystems. And in order to define the technical screening criteria for each objective, the European Commission is enforcing delegated acts. What is the Climate Delegated Act? The Climate Delegated Act introduces the first set of criteria that will define whether an economic activity contributes to two of the environmental goals under the taxonomy regulation: climate change adaptation and climate change mitigation. Now, the Delegated Act covers the economic activities of roughly 40% of the listed companies operating in sectors responsible for almost 80% of the greenhouse gas emissions in Europe. It currently includes sectors such as energy, manufacturing, transport, and buildings. These criteria will further change to include new sectors and economic activities over time. Last but not least, why is the Corporate Sustainability Reporting Directive so important? The directive will create a set of rules that will make sustainability reporting obligatory for big companies. Nearly 50,000 companies in the European Union will now have to follow the new EU sustainability reporting standards. Currently, that number is 11,000 companies. The Commission is also planning to develop proportionate standards for SMEs, which non-listed SMEs can voluntarily use. In the next few years, the business landscape in Europe will have to adjust to the new political reality. As laws are pushing for more sustainable models and fight against greenwashing, are you prepared to evolve? Follow us and check our blog regularly for the newest trends and laws concerning the sustainability and circularity of our economies.